Here in the I button and in the description box below, we will get complete playlist of this chapter. Welcome to video number 29, and this video we are going to study very important formula, that is the Rodrigue's formula. Okay, one of the very important topics of this chapter, that is the Rodrigue's formula. Before I start this video, I would request you to subscribe to my channel. If you haven't subscribed it, then please subscribe it. And if you learn something from my videos, then please hit the like button and please share the playlist of this chapter with your friends. And in this way you can support me. Okay, yes, in this formula we need to prove this, that is Pnx equals to 1 upon 2 to the power n into factorial n, n time differentiation of x square minus 1 power n with respect to x. Okay, yes, we will prove this, and I will be telling you each and every basics of this. Okay, while solving this, whatever comes, I will be telling you every basics. Okay, let us start. To prove this, we will assume, yes, we will suppose that let v equals to x square minus 1 power n. We are taking this, that is x square minus 1 power n equals to v. On differentiating this with respect to x, v will become v1. This will become n times v x square minus 1 power n minus 1 into 2x. Now this can be written as x square minus 1 power n minus 1 power n upon x square minus 1. Because of this negative 1, we can write this in the denominator part. So this is going to be 2nx x square minus 1 power n upon x square minus 1. Now we will take this to the left hand side. This will become x square minus 1 into v1 equals to 2nxv. Okay, now we will take negative common from this, that is this will become, if you take negative common, you will get 1 minus x square, okay, into v1. So okay, in the left hand side, now taking this to the right hand side, you will get 1 minus x square into v1 plus 2nxv. And this is equals to 0. Now here we are going to differentiate. Okay, now we will differentiate, yes, n plus 1 times we are going to differentiate this using Leibniz theorem. Now let us discuss what is Leibniz theorem. Yes, according to Leibniz theorem, if y equals to u into v, if y equals to u into v, where u and v both are function of x, then the nth derivative of y, yes, here we are discussing nth derivative of y, but here we need to differentiate this with respect to x, that is n plus 1 times. Here we are differentiating n times here. Okay, yes, this is my equation. We are differentiating this equation with respect to x n plus 1 times. So what about n times? Yes, according to Leibniz theorem, y, if you differentiate y n times, yes, n times differentiating y with respect to x, you will get yn equals to u n v plus n c 1 u n minus 1 v 1, okay, plus n c 2 u n minus 2 v 2 plus dot dot dot. Again I am saying yn equals to u n v plus n c 1 u n minus 1 v 1 plus n c 2 u n minus 2 v 2, okay, plus dot dot dot. Now we need to know what is NCR equals to factorial n upon factorial r into factorial n minus r. So if you want to find the value of NC1, that is equals to n factorial n upon factorial 1 into factorial n minus 1, that is, yes, we can write factorial n as n into factorial n minus 1. If you cancel both, you will get n. So NC1 is equals to how much? N. Similarly, if you want to find NC2, that is equals to factorial n upon factorial 2 into factorial n minus 2. Okay, yes, since we have factorial n minus 2 in the denominator part, so we will write factorial n equals to n into n minus 1 into factorial n minus 2, so that both will get cancelled, and NC2 is given as n into n minus 1 upon factorial 2. Okay, in this way we have found NC1 as well as NC2. You can also find NC3, NC4 and so on. Okay, yes, so here we need to see, yes, if you use this, let's suppose this is my u and this is my v. Similarly here, yes, this is my u and this part is my v. Okay, now solving this, okay, I mean differentiating this n plus 1 times, yes, n plus 1 time differentiating this with respect to x using Leibniz theorem. So we will get, yes, this was my u, okay, u is what? U is v1, and what is v? V is 1 minus x square, okay, yes. So here it is un. So sorry, un plus 1, because we are differentiating n plus 1 times. So this is going to be bn plus 2, and this is going to be as it is. Then plus, yes, here it should be nc1, but we are differentiating n plus 1 times. So this is going to be n plus 1 c1. Okay, this is going to be bn plus 1, and this we are going to differentiate this with respect to x. So this is going to be minus 2x. Fine. Again, n plus 1 c1 here. In the next term, it is going to be n plus 1 c2. Vn plus 1 is going to be vn. Minus 2x is going to be minus 2. Okay. Yes. Differentiating this part will get minus 2. Okay. This part is over. Now coming to this part. Yes. Here. What? Wait a second. Yes. Here. U is how much? U is v. And v is how much? X. Okay. Now, if you see, this is going to be what? Here. Okay. Solving this part. Okay, yes, that is x times what is u? V. So this is going to be v n plus 1, because we are differentiating v n plus 1 times. So v is going to be v n plus 1, and x will be as it is. In the next term, plus n plus 1 c1. Yes, v n plus 1 will become vn, and differentiation of x will become 1. Okay, now this is going to be 0, because in the next term, differentiation of this will become 0, and this differentiation of this will also become 0. So, okay, now, yes, this part is as it is. Okay, here, yes, n plus 1 c1 can be written as n plus 1, because nc1, the value of nc1 is how much? Yes, that is n. Okay, just now we have discussed that is nc1 is how much? N. In the same way, n plus 1 c1 is going to be n plus 1. Okay, minus 2. X minus 2x into vn plus 1. Here also, yes, nc2 value is how much? N into n minus 1 upon factorial 2. So n plus 1 c2 is going to be n plus 1 into n upon factorial 2. Okay, here we have minus 2 into vn minus 2 vn. Okay, you can cancel this 2 too. Okay, yes. Now here 2n, this is same, n plus 1 c1 is going to be n plus 1 into vn, and this is equals to 0. Fine. Yes, now coming to the next term. Yes, this is going to be, this part is as it is. Now if you take common, that is vn plus 1, here you have minus 2x into n. Yes, minus 2x into 1, that is minus 2x. Fine. Yes, again here also, if you take common vn plus 1, here you have plus 2nx. Okay, yes, these two terms will get cancelled. Now similarly, if you take common, that is vn, here you have with this negative sign, that is n square plus n, with negative sign it is going to be minus n square minus n. Okay, here we have negative sign, and here we have n square plus n, with negative sign it is going to be minus n square minus n. Similarly here also, this is going to be, yes, here we have 2n, and here we have n plus 1, so 2n square, yes, plus 2n. Okay, yes. So coming to the next, yes, this is going to be as it is. Here we are left with minus 2x into vn plus 1, and here we have, yes, 2n square minus n square, that is n square, again 2n minus n, that is plus n. If you take common n, you will get n plus 1. So this is going to be n into n plus 1, vn equals to 0. And this equation, if you closely observe this equation, this equation represents Legendre's equation of order n. Yes, here you can see order n, and has a finite series solution, that is what? That is pnx. Okay, so we can see vn, that is nth derivative of v with respect to x, can be written as c into pnx, and this is what? This is the solution of this equation. Fine. Okay, now we are interested in finding the value of c. Okay, yes, let us find c. So what is c? Okay, we can write this as c into pnx equals to nth derivative of v with respect to x. Okay, n time differentiation of v with respect to x. And what is v? Okay, yes, in the beginning of this proof we have taken, yes, we have supposed that is v equals to x square minus 1 power n. Okay, yes. Okay, So here we can write b as x square minus 1 power n. Now here x square minus 1 square can be written as x minus 1 power n into x plus 1 power n. Okay, x square minus 1 square whole to the power n can be written as x minus 1 power n into x plus 1 power n, because this is going to be a plus b into a minus b. We can use this form, that is a plus b into a minus b form. Now here you should take this as u and this as v. Okay, yes. So again we will use, yes, that is Leibniz theorem. Again, if you see what is the formula, that is y n equals to u n v plus n c 1 u n minus 1 v 1 plus n c 2 u n minus 2 v 2 plus dot dot dot. Okay, yes, again using the same formula here. Yes, here what is u? X minus 1 power n. What is v? X plus 1 power n. So here n time differentiation of this part, okay, into this part. Okay, this part is as it is. Now n c 1 into n minus 1 differentiation of this part into differentiation of this part, okay, plus n c 2 into n minus 2 differentiation of this part into double differentiation of this part plus dot dot dot. Okay, now we need to know what is the value of this as well as this. Okay, for this you need to know successive differentiation formula for, yes, that is ax plus b power n. Okay, that is n time differentiation of ax plus b power n, and the value is m into m minus 1 into m minus 2 plus dot 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 m minus n plus 1 into a key power n into ax plus b power n minus n, m minus n. Okay, yes, here we have three conditions. When m is greater than n, if m is greater than n, then this is going to be a to the power n into factorial m into ax plus b power m minus n upon factorial n minus n. Okay, when m is equals to n, m is equals to n, in that case this is going to be a to the power n into factorial n. And if m is less than n, if m is less than n, then this is going to be how much? 0. Okay, yes. So if you compare this, that is x minus 1 with ax plus b, you will get a equals to 1 and b equals to minus 1. Okay, so here writing, okay, let me find these three values, okay, one by one. So I have written here, yes, that is we need to find these three values first. Okay, so if you see, the value of m is how much? N, and n is also n. Okay, here m is n is n, and both are same. So we are going to put m equals to n formula here. So formula is a to the power n into factorial n. And what is a? A is 1. So 1 to the power n into factorial n. And the value of this is going to be factorial n. Fine. Again, we need to find, yes, second part, that is d, yes, n minus 1 derivative of this part, that is x minus 1 power n. Here m is n is n minus 1. Okay, yes, and we know that this is greater than this. Okay, this is greater than this, so we can say m is greater than n. So we are going to put this formula here. Okay, here again a to the power n, that is 1 to the power n factorial m, and the value of m is how much? N. Okay, this is factorial n. Here it is going to be x minus 1 power m minus n. What is m? M is n. What is n? N is n minus 1. So this is going to be m minus n, that is m n minus n plus 1. So n will get cancelled. We'll be left with, yes, x minus 1 power 1 with this factorial n upon, yes, m minus n, that is factorial n minus n plus 1. So n will get cancelled. You will be left with factorial 1. Fine. Okay. Again, d to the power n minus 2 into x power x minus 1 power n, that is n minus 1 n minus 2 differentiation of, okay, this part, that is x minus 1 power n. Again, you can see m is n and n is n minus 2, and if you compare this value is greater, that is m is greater than n. So again we are going to put this formula here. Okay, so here also you can see, okay, a to the power n, that is 1 to the power n into factorial m. What is m? M is n. Okay, so this is going to be factorial n. Again, ax plus b is how much? X minus 1. okay, power m minus n, that is this minus this, that is this minus this, that is yes n minus n plus 2 upon again this part, that is because here we have n minus n and here also we have m minus n, so this is factorial n minus n plus 2, again n and n will get cancelled, so you will get factorial n into x minus 1 power 2 upon factorial 2. Okay, in this way you can find other values also. Okay, yes, let's go. So we had this formula, okay, we had this series, that is nth derivative of x minus 1 power n into x plus 1 power n plus nc1 n minus 1 derivative of x minus 1 power n differentiation of x plus 1 power n plus nc2 n minus 2 derivative of x minus 1 power n second derivative of x plus 1 power n. So we have this formula, okay, we have the formula for this, that is nth derivative of x minus 1 power n. Okay, what is that? Yes, this is how much? Factorial n. Okay, so simply write factorial n into x plus 1 power n. Okay, again x n plus 1, so nc1 can be written as n, n minus 1 derivative of this part. Okay, let me see what is that. Yes, factorial n into x minus 1 power 1 upon factorial 1. So this is factorial n into x minus 1 power n 1 upon factorial 1. Okay, yes, into differentiation of this part, that is differentiation of x plus 1 power n, and this is going to be x, sorry, n into x plus 1 power n minus 1. Again, coming to this part, third part, that is nc2 can be written as n into n minus 1 upon factorial 2, n minus 1, okay, n minus 2 differentiation of x minus 1 power n. Okay, the value is how much? The value of this is how much? Factorial n x minus 2 power 2 upon factorial 2. Okay, yes. Again, double differentiation of this is going to be n into n minus 1 into x plus 1 power n minus 2 plus dot dot dot. Okay, this is what? This is was. This is the value for c pnx, c into pnx. But we want c. For that, we will put x equals to 1. Okay, so this is going to be c into p1. Sorry, this is going to be c into pn1. Okay, because we are putting x equals to 1, so this is going to pn1 into c, and this is equals to, okay, we are left with only this term, because here we have x minus 1 power 1, here we have x minus 1 power 2, in the next term you will get x minus 1 power 3 and so on. Okay, if you put x equals to 1 here, this term is going to be 0, again this term is also going to be 0, and the further terms will also be going to be 0, so we have only this term, that is x plus 1 power n. So if you put x equals to 1, so this is going to be 2 to the power n into factorial n. So here we can say, yes, again in the previous video, that is in video number 28, I have also told you that pn1, okay, at x equals to 1, pnx equals to how much? 1. That is pn at x equals to 1 is how much? 1. So this is going to be 1. So finally we can see c is equals to 2 to the power n into factorial 2. Okay, c is equals to 2 to the power n into factorial 2. Okay, so we can see from equation number 1. What is equation number 1? Let me show you once again. Yes, this is my equation number 1. Okay, yes. So here we can see n time differentiation of x square minus 1 power n with respect to x, which is equals to c into pnx is equals to, yes, what is c? 2 to the power n into factorial n. So 2 to the power n into factorial n into pnx. But we want pnx. So pnx is equals to 1 upon 2 to the power n into factorial n into n time differentiation of x square minus 1 power n with respect to x. And finally, we have proved it. Okay. Yes. Finally, we have proved this Rodrigue's formula. Fine. Yes. After this, we need to know certain Legendre's polynomial. Okay. To find that, we need to put n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Okay, yes, in this equation we are going to put n equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on. So if you put n equal to 0, okay, if you put n equal to 0, so you will get p0x, p naught x equals to how much? 1. In the same way, if you put n equals to 1 in this Rodrigue's formula, you will get p1x equals to 1 upon 2, okay, d upon dx of x square minus 1 power 1. Okay, yes, on differentiating this will, you will get 2x, 2 2 will get cancelled, so p1x will be how much? X. Again, if you want to find p2x, so you need to put 2 in place of n, So this is going to 1 upon 2 to the power 2 into factorial 2 into double differentiation of x square minus 1 power 2. Okay, here we are going to use the formula that is a minus b whole square, that is a square minus 2ab plus b square. So this is going to be x to the power 4 minus 2x square plus 1. Again, if you differentiate this, we'll get 4x cube minus 2x, okay, 2x. Yes, again, if you take 2 full common, you will get 4 upon 8, that is 1 upon 2. Again, differentiation of x cube minus x. Okay, again, if you differentiate this, we'll get 3x square minus 1 upon 2. So we can see P2x is equals to how much? 3x square minus 1 upon 2. Similarly, you can find the value for P3x, that is 1 upon 2 times 5x cube minus 3x. Similarly, you can find the value for P4x, and that is how much? 1 upon 8 times 35x power 4 minus 30x square plus 3. And you can find the value for P5x, that is 1 upon 8, 63x power 5 minus 70x to the power 3 plus 15x, and so on. In the same way, you can find the value for P6x, P7x, P8x, and so on. Okay, yes, by using all this Legendre's polynomial, okay, we are going to solve one problem in the next video. Okay, so thank you so much for watching this video. Thank you.